Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of the UFO Planet Sightings and News Report. I'm your host, Darren Crapo. On today's program, as usual, I'm going to show you some of the most recently submitted UFO sightings from around the planet. We're going to get that started right after this. Welcome back to the program. I hope you all had a splendid week while I took an unannounced, unexpected week away from UFO Planet to deal with my other responsibilities in my job. I'll explain a little bit more about that later on in today's program, but we're going to start right away with the headline news. I have a couple of interesting news stories on today's program that I thought might interest you, my audience. The first one comes to us from Fox 31 in Denver, Colorado. There was a UFO and ghost investigators descend on a small Colorado town. Now, this just happened just this weekend, and it sounded like it was an amazing time. You can see in the photograph there, you can see the group of them gathered together. There were about 200 people who attended this event, and it was of all places in Cripple Creek. And there's a whole lot of songs written about Cripple Creek, both some blues and some rock and roll. So it's kind of a mining community that is well known for having a lot of hauntings. Anyway, at the conference, there was Chuck Sikowski, and Chuck spoke to the fact that there were about 8 cattle mutilations in Arizona earlier this year. Now, we haven't heard a lot about cattle mutilations in the past while, but apparently there were 8 at one time. It used to happen all the time back in the late 70s and early 80s, back when I was in high school. And let me tell you, it certainly kept us from parking with our girlfriends out in ranch country back in those days, because we were all afraid of the cattle mutilators because it was happening to everyone around us. But anyway, that was the topic of discussion, one of the main topics by Chuck Sikowski at this event that was in Cripple Creek. And it would be nice to have some of those people on the program in the future, and we're certainly going to try for that for Planet Plus. It's always great to see that people are getting together in the name of ufology and in the name of research. I think that is absolutely spectacular. Next, you guys, we're going to head over to Russia. This is an interesting news story. It was posted on Yahoo News this weekend, and the name of it is A Mysterious Disc Discovered in Russia. A UFO theorist claims the object is a million-year-old spaceship. How amazing is that? Now, we're going to take a look at the photo here that comes with it, and that is the Russian researcher there that claims they have found more than one of these discs in the past. Kind of an amazing shape to it. Definitely looks like a UFO, what we'd all like a saucer to look like. Whether or not it's a saucer, I have really no idea. But I better be careful there. I'm tripping over my mic cable here. There, so we can have a closer look at it. It looks like some sort of a, you know, petrified UFO. I guess that's what they're trying to sell it as. Vadim Chernobrov is the head of the Russian UFO group that has discovered more than one of these rocks in the past. I guess they call them stone UFOs. Now, I'm not sure. It's not flying. So we managed to find a dozen of these stone discs, but this is such a unique one, he told the local media. Other stones we found are not more than 1 meter in diameter. Previously, we have been able to find such alien stones, but the biggest of them found was in Kubas, which was one of 2 meters in diameter. So that comes from Vadim Chernobrov, who is the person that you see there holding up this stone in the photo. Now, one thing that was a little bit confusing within this story is, at first, they made it sound like this stone was 2 meters. Now, I'm not sure how tall this guy is, but that's no 2 meter stone. And now here they're saying it's a 4 meter disc. That's definitely not 4 meters, because that would tower over this guy when he was standing up. Unless, of course, he's from the land of the giants. And as far as I know, they don't have any giants over there in Russia. They just have stone UFOs, or stones that are in the shape of flying saucers. Maybe they were replicas of what people saw in the past. Who really knows? But it's an interesting discovery. What do you guys make of that? Do you think it's a petrified UFO, or do you think someone saw a UFO and carved one out to make it look like that? Speaking of UFOs, we have a lot of UFO sightings coming up today on the program, including an amazing sighting from down in Costa Rica that some people say was God.
UFO Planet.
Welcome back to the program. I thought I would just take a moment and just mention why there were no programs last week. I sat down ready to do the program on Monday, and we ended up with a Amber Alert here in southern Alberta, actually in all of Alberta, for a missing 2-year-old girl. Now, most of you who have been following me online for the 3 years that I've been doing UFO Planet also know that I work at Alberta Police Report. And so when that kind of business takes precedence, unfortunately, the little 2-year-old girl was found deceased, and so was her father. So it was a real sad time here in Alberta last week. We're going to get started, though, right away into our UFO sightings. These are UFO sightings that are submitted to 4U2CTV and to MUFON from worldwide. First, we're going to head to Fort Worth, Texas for a sighting shot on September 12th. This was sighting number 70411 for those of you who check them out on the MUFON site. Here we are in Fort Worth, Texas, and there seems to be a lot of sightings there. Now, this one. You look at it and you think to yourself right away, what an amazing orb caught in with a formation of military jets. That is, until you see this big nasty sun right up there, and then that orb just kind of goes to a sunspot, or a lens flare. There were dozens of these submitted in the last 2 weeks, guys. I'm just going to be blunt. Stop pointing your cameras at the sun. You're going to ruin them. And you can see this is a professional photography site, and they show you what lens flare is. So we have the sun up there, and you see the white orbs. So I bet you, out of all the sightings that were submitted this week, there were probably 25 of them that were lens flare. Again, stop pointing your cameras towards the sun. Next, we're going to go to Prescott, Arizona in the United States of America, August 16th, this sighting. Sighting number 70572 with MUFON. And I appreciate everyone who submits their sightings to MUFON. It helps make the program much more interesting. And this is one of the ones that really makes it interesting. This is a photograph. It's one of those photographs where someone snapped the photo, but didn't notice the object in it until later. But take a look at this object. Certainly doesn't look like your typical creature that you'd see flying through the air. A bug or an insect or a bird or anything like that. It's kind of an amazing looking sighting when you look at it in a single frame, but sometimes a single frame can be deceiving, folks. You really don't get enough information, but nonetheless, it's great to look at. Kissimmee, Florida is where we're gonna go to next. Kissimmee, I'm not sure how you pronounce that. August 19, 2015, MUFON case 70626. This is an interesting sighting from down there. And I really appreciate all of you who take the time. Now, let's take a look at this one from Kissimmee, Florida. To me, when I looked at this, the first thing that popped into my head was that someone caught a great video of someone flying their drone, because it definitely has that lead light looking thing. And if you look really closely at this object, you can see that the lights are in a quad formation. There's not three there, like it kind of looks most of the time. There's actually four. So in Kissimmee, Florida, there's a good possibility that this may have been a drone, and it might not have been a drone. Who really knows? Now we're going to go to Felton, Pennsylvania for a September 17th sighting. There was also a lot of sightings that led up to this sighting. There's also audio included. So let's listen in and see what happens in Felton.
September 17th, 2015. This is like the second week I've been observing these flashing white and red lights, sometimes blue, in the east or west sky. This one tonight has been really strange.
Unexplained lights in the sky over Felton. And that happens all over the world every day. There are dozens of people who see things up in the air that they are unable to explain. Those qualify as unidentified flying objects. Do they qualify as extraterrestrials? Absolutely not. Not until we see them come out of the craft and come for a tea and crumpets with us, I guess we're just going to have to speculate. But if you happen to catch a sighting of one, I would love to hear from you. DarrenIt4U2CTV.com, and also consider submitting your sighting to MUFON.com so the experts can take a look. There's a lot more coming up on today's program, so I'd really appreciate if you stick around. We have an amazing sighting from Costa Rica that I said before, and I'll say again, some people think it was God.
They will see his face on television. This is number one. They'll see his face on TV, but his lips won't move. They will hear his words in their head telepathically in whatever their native language is. So people will be startled. They'll be, he's not talking, but I'm hearing him. Are you hearing him? I'm hearing him. It'll be one of those kind of experiences. That's the first way you'll know it's him. The second way you'll know it's him is that he can embody, he built his physical body from nothing.
UFO Planet.
Welcome back to the program. I'd just like to take a minute before I move on to the five sightings in a row and just thank everybody who posts comments on the YouTube channel. YouTube isn't the only place where you can watch UFO Planet now. You can also watch it on Roku streaming television. But I would just like to send a very special thank you to the many who have recently joined the UFO Planet family. And I just want to mention to you that we have a very strict policy for commenting on the program. Basically, if you're rude and obnoxious, we show you the door without apology. And that is a policy that we've had in place for 3 years now. And it makes the channel a lot more interesting and a lot more exciting for the people that are really interested in the study of UFOs instead of the study of failing mental health. Well, it's time for us to move on to our sightings, five sightings in a row. Some amazing stuff. A lot of these have audio with them, which is what I really appreciate. If you take the time to describe your video, you're almost certain to make it in my top five sightings. Let's have a look and see what arrived this week. Well, that's not going to do it. We don't want to do the hot video clip of the day. So let's hit the right button here, folks. Albuquerque, New Mexico in the United States first. You'd think I'd know how to run this studio after all the time that I've spent here. This one has audio, so listen up.
In the backyard again, and you know, bringing this, see if we can bring this into focus here. And then I can try to find it again. go. Let's see how close I can get. This is all the way out. This is as close as I can get to this plane. Well, it looks like a plane anyways. Yeah, it's starting to get a little more clarity in it. Uh-oh.
September 17th, 2015. This is like the
that's eight times
second
week on
this I've been observing
LG
these flashing
G3
white and red
camera.
Lights, sometimes blue.
You see the clarity in
the east or west sky.
Close-ups.
This one tonight has been really strange.
They're flying like around the airplane in the chemtrails.
And stuff like that. Let me see if I can turn it sideways here. Let's see if I can get a full picture. There you go. Yeah, so there's some odd things that happen around airplanes.
Thank you, Tim Gorman, for sending in a known video of an aircraft so we could compare. Next, we're going to go to Ohio in the United States of America. Always remember, people, it's no secret, you know, that if you give up your information, if you're afraid to give your information of where you're located, it really distracts from the ability to research. Listen up to this one.
That's it. I just got it.
Is that not what came over last night?
Yeah. But the one I saw at the close encounter had the red light underneath. That's it. I just got it.
Is that not what came over last night?
Yeah. But the one I saw at the close encounter had the red light underneath.
Next, we're going to go to Balcombe Hills. This is from Melissa Kennedy and Damien Knott. They're from the Australian Aerial Phenomena Investigations team down there. They have a couple of sightings, plus a really interesting shot that Damien shot here with this helicopter. Now, some orbs appeared right after this helicopter video was shot, but this is one of the better. This is a great shot of a helicopter, Damien. You definitely have some talent there with the camera. It's incredibly difficult to shoot something like that that's moving while you're holding the camera in your hands without a tripod. But now, shortly after this, a helicopter, some orbs appeared. But let's take a look at what they saw down there in Australia.
Actually see it through the viewfinder now for the first time.
A really interesting orb captured by Melissa here. You can see how incredibly difficult it is to capture these things on film. So this is a replay in slow motion now, so we can kind of see that we have something there that tends to have quite a glow to it. I myself don't see any wings on the side of it, but it certainly has a definite glow. Now, is that glare from the sun, or is that light being generated by the object itself? Next, we're going to take a look at the video that was shot by Damien on the same day as this video that was shot by Melissa.
Mm.
there we have Damien's footage. Now we're going to take a look at a close-up and some slow-mos of what Damien captured. These were both what Melissa and Damien captured were both shot on exactly the same day. And very, very interesting to look at. There's a lot of these type of objects up in the sky, and they're certainly not easy to debunk or to explain. The Australian Aerial Phenomena Investigation Team down there are looking into a lot of the sightings down in Australia. You need to get a hold of Damien and Melissa if you have some sightings down there. They have an awesome website up there that you can check out. Damien was actually a guest on Planet Plus, so go watch that episode and you'll find out all of his information. Mid-July, Palmer, Massachusetts, Scott Brown in the field. Scott is an amazing guy. I asked him to do an audio narration for me and fired off to me, and he did. So let's listen to what he had to say from In the Field, Scott Brown, 2015.
This was recorded during the day using an infrared camera. As it filmed, I sat next to the camera with binoculars pointed in the same direction as the camera. There were no planes in the sky, and the sky had very few clouds. This object could not be seen with the naked eye or looking through the binoculars. This video was shot in mid-July 2015 in Palmer, Massachusetts.
Next, we're going to take a look at the latest installment from Jeremy Thomas down in Redland, Florida. Jeremy uses some amazing equipment and captures some amazing anomalies over Redland. This bizarre anomaly was spotted in infrared. Vertical, thin, undulating anomalies had been observed multiple times already when he captured this footage. And it's hard to see there. It's kind of difficult. But that footage that we just looked at was captured by the camera here on the left. Now, Jeremy's going to hook up the camera on the right, which has a 1,000 millimeter telephoto lens and 140 times optical zoom. And he's going to show us what the same object looks like. First, we're going to take a look at some still frames. Isn't this amazing, you guys? What is this? Now, you take a look at the still frames. It doesn't say a lot to you. But wait until you start to see these anomalies in motion. There we go. Telephoto segment at normal speed. So that could be way, way, way out there, because Jeremy's capturing these with this amazing equipment that'll capture something way out there. Every time Jeremy sends me something, it's something I've never seen before, ever, and unexplainable. So I would really be interested. You know, there's a lot of people who consider themselves debunkers out there. What do you guys think this is? What is Jeremy capturing? I don't think you're going to have an easy time debunking that one. But pretty amazing, Jeremy. I really appreciate when I hear from my regulars who are avid shooters of UFO videos, because in order to capture a UFO, you got to have your camera out there, and these people do. There's a lot more to look at yet. Well, one more clip, actually, and it's an amazing one who some people say was God appearing in Costa Rica.
UFO Planet.
Welcome back to the program. Before I head into our hot video clip of the day, I just want to finish talking about what I was speaking about a little bit earlier about comments, and just add that I really do appreciate those of you who do take the time to comment. But it's kind of amazing. I can always tell when someone has picked up the For You To See TV stream with the UFO Planet videos in them, because I will immediately have to kind of get rid of a couple of the people that just have bitter, twisted attitudes. And we do all of this for fun. I donate all my time to UFO Planet. I'm not getting rich doing this. I spend approximately 40 hours a week on the program. So seriously, if you have nothing nice to say, beat it, get out. You know, I used to listen to Art Bell, and I used to kind of chuckle when he would say things like this and just tell the people that are sending the nasty emails and that right off. Like, I'm not going to tell people to go to hell, even though sometimes I honestly feel that way. But if you have nothing nice to say, just simply leave and go somewhere else, and we'll all go on being happy. But for those amazing people who give the awesome comments, I just want to really totally compliment you, because the way you comment online tells me a lot about the type of person that you are. So if your comment's really nice and analytical about the topic, I can tell that you're an intelligent person. But if it's just a really nasty comment, either demeaning someone who made the video, myself or anyone else on the planet, I can tell that it's been a while since you've been to your doctor and you probably need your meds adjusted. But in any case, I just really want to drive home the point that if you want to use the privilege to comment on our For You To See TV channels, use the privilege wisely, or we'll show you the door with no apologies. You just have to be that way online, because there's a lot of whack jobs out there. There really are. It's time now to take a look at our hot video clip of the day. Kind of losing place of where I am in today's program. I guess that's what happens when you got too many things on your mind. But it's time now to take a look at that hot video clip coming to us from Costa Rica.
You guys, I have never seen anything like this. This is the sky here in Escazú, Costa Rica. And look at the sky. It's absolutely... it's like a sign of God. Here you have the normal mountains. Wow.
Dude, the middle is like green.
I know.
Like might not be a good idea to look at it for
it's long. Like the Lord is going to come through those clouds any moment.
Escazú, Costa Rica. Wasn't that an amazing sighting? There's always something amazing going on somewhere, isn't there? I just want to say thanks to everyone who has participated in today's program, whether it is by making a comment or simply watching the program. I really do appreciate it. And I really appreciate those who contribute to the program with their submissions. And I just want to say thanks to everyone who has sent in emails asking where I was last week. We're all back in business here, and hopefully if we have no more Amber Alerts, we'll keep things going. I just want to say thanks for watching the show. I'm Darren Crapo. I'll see you again on Thursday.